The financial impact of COVID-19 could take years to fully understand. What we do know is that not every Canadian was dealt the same hand. Mike Drolet takes a look at the uneven economic impact of the last year.
You could excuse Canadians for being dizzy from the year of COVID, in and out of lockdown, time and again. And while the health crisis unfolded, the economy took a beating.
Yeah, I think one thing, regardless of how you fared during COVID, it threw a stick of dynamite on everyone's finances.
But economic downturns are as unfair as they are devastating. For every Canadian who needed government assistance to make ends meet, another was socking away money they would normally have spent on luxuries like travel. Financial expert Kelly Keene has been speaking with both.
That camp over there that has some extra money, they're actually reaching out to me saying they're kind of embarrassed to even talk about it because they know so many people are suffering. And the people that are suffering are still dealing with that conversation of, you know, tax time's coming up. They may owe money.
Industry was no different. After months of losses, StatsCan reports retail numbers have rebounded and real estate is breaking sales records every month. And restaurants continue to struggle, along with anything related to tourism and travel. Add it all up, and it's a confusing mess for new graduates.
There aren't as many jobs out there.
When Patty Facey graduated with a master's degree in information, she didn't expect anything to be handed to her, but she believed there would be more.
And if you are somebody that just was unlucky enough to graduate right now, you've kind of slipped through the cracks when it comes to government relief.
She's not wrong. 2020 grads didn't qualify for the CERB, nor did they get tax relief on tuition like current students. Instead, they received the far more frugal student benefit and no help on student loan payments.
People want to be productive. People just feel very disillusioned with the fact that we're, you know, as a generation, so saddled with debt that maybe we can't have the same sort of economic participation as our parents did, you know, buying homes or investing or saving for retirement.
Painting the Canadian financial picture has never been so confusing. Mike Drolet, Global News, Toronto.